Hey guys, it's Harma with the Harma Channel. Today we'll be talking about is a fixer for you. I get these questions all the time from other buyers if I have any fixer available for them. Usually for some buyers, they never done anything like that, but they're interested to build an equity. And I completely understand that. On this video, we will be talking about some pros and cons, some negatives, some positives, and I'm gonna share four or five things that you should know. But before I do that, let me share a story about my own project that happened recently. It was a single family home in Sherman Oaks that was 40 years untouched. The pool was green, and I mean green, not because of the color of the water, the tiles were green. I guess it was fashionable at one point to use green tiles. But what I'd like to share is that when I finished the project, it was March 5th, and we all know pandemic hit. I have experienced the crash, I learned out of it a lot, but I didn't know what pandemic meant. At that period, for 2 months, I was very confused. I didn't know, should I reduce the price? Should I hold on to my project? Luckily, market shifted, and I ended up selling the property with profit. But one thing that I did smart, that I stick to the budget. When I remodeled this place, I used the budget, I finished the project based on what the outcome was, just if I sell it for what I spent on. I would just break even. And guess what? The market was supporting that price. So I was fine. I ended up with profit, but remember, this is what this segment is about, that I want to teach you that always stick with your budget. But let's start with some negatives. If you are a full-time employee or you have a job somewhere else full-time and you're planning to fix something, someone has to supervise this project. Who's gonna do that? If you hire a contractor to do that, you have to pay them. If you're gonna do it, who's gonna do your other job? So that's one negative about it. Number two, every project, 99% of the time, goes over the budget. And you have to have extra reserve for surprises that you might have. And number three, the living cost, or I like to call it carrying cost. So if you are living somewhere else while you're remodeling, or you're renting, you should calculate every month that it's gonna cost you to rent that place. Or the property taxes, the water and power, the insurance, the mortgage, that while you're remodeling, that's called carrying cost. That should be considered part of the budget. Let's talk about some positives. Number one, you get to build this house the way you like it. You pick the color, you pick the faucet, all the fixtures, it's gonna be the way you like it. And number two, you build an equity. Of course, that's exciting. You build for your future. That's an amazing opportunity. And last thing, I love how positive the project can become, how fun it is, and the journey can be really cool, and you learn so much out of it. And before we finish the segment, what about I share four things that I have made a mistake on, and I see others do as well, so you won't have to do that again. Number one. Don't hire your best friend or someone who's just new in the business. I'm talking about contractor, the plumber, the AC, whoever you're hiring. They don't have an experience, it is likely they're gonna mess up and you're gonna be the guinea pig. And if it's a friend, it's very difficult to fire them. And remember, the cheapest person is gonna cost you a lot more than the expert in their field. Number two, if you don't have cash to remodel, you should not think about remodeling. You don't borrow against your property, or you don't use your credit card to put a new kitchen. What kind of equity is that when you're just borrowed from someone else? That's not your money. So you save up, then you remodel. You don't have to do it all the house at the same time, but you may want to consider how much money do you have when you buy a fixer? Do you have enough for the down payment and remodeling and reserve and the surprises? Or no, you just have enough for the down payment, then guess what? No, fixer is not for you. Number three, pick the product that fits in the budget, not the product that you go out there, you love it, and then you just like, oh my God, I like to do granite countertop. Well, you budget it for quartz. Guess what? The budget will go up and then you will run out of money somewhere else. And the last thing, when you buy a fixer, it is your job to do all you can do, investigate, hire the best inspectors to find out what's wrong with the house. It is not just the cosmetic things you're gonna change. It's much easier to change the floors and the bathrooms and bam, you're done. you're actually not done if the roof has an issue and then gutters have to be replaced after the roof, or there's a beautiful tree in the front lawn that is a 40 years old, and then guess what? Where do you think the roots are? Inside your sewer line, and you have to change that. The windows have to be changed, the termite, and on. But the things that you don't see, such as electrical and plumbing, make sure you look into that before you close your escrow, because those are very, very costly and can eat up your entire budget. Well, I hope you liked this video, and remember, remodeling is fun and exciting, and also it causes a lot of divorces. So please remember what are you looking for and make it fun, otherwise it can be very stressful. And if you made a mistake, it's okay. Feel free to email me. I'm happy to help you and ask any question so you don't make the same mistakes. And good luck.